Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. This is the one and only SiloMan coming to you from a launch control facility of a former Atlas F intercontinental ballistic missile site outside of Roswell, New Mexico, USA. For the next 14 minutes, please enjoy yourself. I'm going to take you through some of the last section of old photographs that'll show you some of the work that we've done over the past 20 years and are just about to finish this site. Here you can see up on the surface, you can see we're finally filling in the pit. You can see the line there on the left, that's going to go to the new water tank that's going to give us water underground. We have temporary water underground by that portable tank. Had a couple individuals climb the tower and they're putting on the Wi-Fi antennas for me. And we're getting ready to pour the post for the commercial satellite. See, we've already run the line to it, the electrical line and the connectivity line, I should say. See how the antenna's up on the tower? Again, looking at the tower. The two additional flagpoles. There you have it. We have the state of New Mexico, the MIA flag. There we've got the satellite dish up. And there you have, we've got our temporary water tank there that we provide. We have a minimum of always 500 gallons on the surface like that. And there's that 1,000-gallon tank that I was talking about earlier that we were going to put in. And it's basically just a ground level. I'm just bringing in the portable to fill it up. We'll make two trips. That portable can carry a little over 500 gallons. And we're just backfilling around it. It's a fairly easy job. Little different angle. That was us bringing it in. And there you have it. There we've got it in the ground. We're coming around. We still got, well, the dirt that's really needed to finish this pit area, we've gone ahead and used on the eastern side, to give us a bit more of a parking area. And so I'm left with the choice of we'll probably be, you know, either digging down or I'll have them bring in some dirt for us and we can fill that in and get a level. There's the emergency backup generator. That's a really slick unit. It's 15 kW, 15,000 watts. And of course we're setting it on the old UHF antenna pad. We cleaned out, you saw those pictures that we cleaned out, the 4-inch line that goes from there into the comm manhole, and then from the comm manhole into the upper level of the control center. And there we're simply just starting to wire it in. And there we've got it wired. You can see that we're at this point going to start running the gas line. We don't have the gas tank. You'll be seeing it. It'll come in and be set. There we got it, the tank. I want to get a bigger one. That one, oh geez, this one's probably going back to 2005. So I'm taking you back 15 years with this. I'd like to have one about 4 or 5 times that big, and then eventually go to a diesel where we'll put it underground in the tunnel to the air exhaust shaft. And there we're doing a little of the grading around where we had to dig up. But it come out pretty good. You can see that pole in the background. We're about to run electricity. We're about to put in the service pole here at the site. We basically built this whole thing off of a 5,500 watt gas generator. And really wasn't bad. Granted, my dad and I, it took us right at 2.5 years to do what you've seen in these photographs. So that was normally working 6 days a week. So it's really been a fun project. One of the last other sites that I've done, and I'll be showing you pictures of that, I had a 16-man crew. So it's real easy to finish quickly when you have 16 people working with you. But for this portion right here, it was just my father and I, and I think my dad at that time was pushing 80 years old, so it was a lot of fun. I think it kept him in this old world for a few more years, and that I'm truly thankful. Well, anyway, you can see where we've had that pole. And we've got her in the ground at this point. We'll go ahead and have the meter loop put on it. We'll have a fuse 200 amp disconnect and the box. And at that point, then they'll bring in the power to us. Now we've got the escape shaft open. And the door, we put a cord. Air exhaust shaft. The other shaft is the filling vent. There's the filling vent. A little closer look. That little manhole that you see there is for the silo sump. It's all the way at the very bottom of the silo. It has two small sumps. And then we had some. The Air Force originally had some pretty big, I think 7.5 horsepower pumps. They pump any of that collected water up to there, and then from there it ran off. Where you see that large salt cedar on the south side of the property, that's the outfall for the silo water. It's probably one of the reasons that salt cedar did so well during the years. And you can see where they've gone ahead and run the line over to our temporary pole. We just haven't had the meter loop completed where they're connected. Power company has run us in the poles along the access road. Set the transformer. Still doing a little work on the side of the access road. Some brush artwork in the background. Here's the 200 amp fuse disconnect. We're just simply got the meter base in place. Just waiting for the state electrical inspector to sign off and they'll set us the meter. And they've installed the meter. Come out well, really did. site's looking really clean versus some of those pictures that you saw when you first walked on it. You're going to see a few of the aerials we shot. I shot those from our airplane. It'll give you an idea of back then. I mean, I'd love to have had a drone. I look at these now and I can't wait to get one and try it. They just look fun. And you don't always have to take the plane, and so much easier. And that's the way she looked when we got started. There's the site. You see the entryway. There's the old access road into her. You see the old evaporation ponds off to the side. You see the Quonset hut pads. This is looking south, obviously from the north. And looking from the south, looking north, you can see the entryway, that little white speck down there. We've already thrown some in. See the silo, round silo cap area. See the two concrete pads back there for the Quonset huts. You can see the evaporation ponds that we have. This site has roughly 13 acres. It has two very, very large evaporation ponds. And again, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you've enjoyed these old photographs. I appreciate your attention. If you would, please subscribe, click that bell. Please leave a comment, and if you like what you've seen, give me a thumbs up. Truly look forward to hearing from you all, and thank you so very much.